I escaped the lair of the eyeless, and as they died, their souls left their bodies. I was able to speak with them. They are fragments of the soul of Abaddon himself. I decided to allow them to return to their master, so that he might remember the past, and that he was once the god of preservation.
Lead the way.
You okay? Surprised she doesn't have anything to say with her brush with death. Oh wow. Well, we got to go take a look.
Got it.
Land has really been changed here. Unfortunately, there's nothing much to see. We really can't get close to anything. Where are they going? They can't go in. Okay, I guess we're... Let's return to Stalwart then. We still have another thing to do in the White March Part 2. We have to go to this marsh or grave, something like that. Something having to do with Console Heart. Someone's been watching us or trying to find us or something. It's Mograk Fen. We need to go there, but that will be after all this. Let me just check this. Make sure nothing undid itself. Nope, looks good. You've done it again. Hopefully we can enjoy some real peace now. That's all I had to say. You did it! You beat those metal horrors!
Hey there! Let me know if you need anything. Take care!
And you know, I didn't use a single potion of endurance or regeneration for all these battles. Not too hard. We'll finally get good roads and something to eat besides fish.
Back to warm your hands, eh? What can I do for you? Top quality bear pelts?
Fresh rest here. Out of jam again. What a disaster. The ogres are fine. They're not gonna harm you now. Oh, Yeah, nothing much to say. Oh wait, does he have camping supplies? Because I'll buy a couple.
Back to warm your hand, Jay. What can I do for you? Nothing like a...
Yeah, shit. It would be at the bottom, I'm pretty sure. Nope. I'd have to find some somewhere else. So, little Tarfos, we should post guards at the gate, keep an eye on who's coming in. Like, I'm not a fan of, like, huge challenging combat. I mean, it's fine. But, I mean, if I was, I'd be really disappointed. They were not hard at all, these things. Royce, who's that? This woman looks at you like she's used to hearing bad news. She shakes her head and holds up her hands before you can even begin. Look, you can tell Hammond that I ain't seen Mylla all day, and besides, he ought to keep a better eye on his shop if he don't want little uns poking around. She folds her arms and plants her feet wide. Hammond? Yeah, Hammond. He's new around here. Set up a tent where Katie's house was lost in the fire. She looks at you as though you should know what he's talking about. Yeah, Hammond's Emporium, I believe, right? Stare through her. Sure, I've been there, but... Oh, I didn't recognize you. You're the one who opened up the battery, aren't you? Royce looks both embarrassed and nervous as she stumbles over her words. It's just that she... My daughter, Mylla, I mean, she spent times over at Hammond's tent... Gets underfoot. She shrugs, exhausted and exasperated. Figured he sent someone over to complain about her. Again. But you ain't here about her, huh? You don't know where your own child is? That's a stupid way. That's a really... I wouldn't ask with that tone of voice, but I don't have a choice. She backs away like she's been slapped. Yeah, I really didn't want to say it like that. I didn't say that. Unable to look you in the eyes, her gaze darts to the ground, her cheeks flushed with embarrassment. But it's hard keeping track of her, what with all the commotion around here lately. Do you have any idea where Mylla might be? She's been out for quite a while now. That's nothing new. She chews her lip, wondering. Still, I can't help but worry that she's gone and gotten herself into some trouble. If you could keep an eye or two open for her while you're in town, I'd greatly appreciate it. Shrugging vaguely nod. I'll make sure she's not in any trouble. Oh, thank you. Everyone is so busy this day with the mines and the forge opening back up again. It's kind of you to help. I have a few questions for you. Need something? What drawing? Do you recognize this place? She squints at it. Mountains and a cave? Lots of those. A lot of those in these parts. She squints. Those lines there could be standing stones, like the one at Whitestone Hollow. Ugh. Huh. I don't know why she would go off there. Did we find this thing? I don't remember. It's been a while since we were in Whitestone Hollow. Is there some place Mylla likes to run off to? She often takes off to Hammond's Emporium. She shrugs. Has a problem with looking at things instead of touching them. Hammond's been on my back the past few days to keep her away. Might her father know where she's gone? Please don't worry him. He's in enough trouble at his job already. She smiles weakly. Truly, all of us appreciate what you did, opening the battery back up. Folks like my Ludgar are making good money patching up all the damage out front. Please don't set his mind spinning about where Mylla is. Well, he's her father. If she's in trouble, it isn't right to hide it from him. And I'm her mother. A wrinkle of annoyance creases her forehead. I know you're trying to help, but I really think it's best not to distract Ludgar while he's working. Okay. Wild Mylla. You know, there's a cave that we found, like, there was, like, completely nothing in it. Maybe that's where she was. Mylla's been getting herself into trouble around Starwort lately. Her mother, Royce, hasn't seen her, but mentioned that she has been bothering Hammond, the new shopkeeper. Royce mentioned that her husband, Ludgar, is stationed at Durgan's Battery. She told me not to mention Mylla's disappearance to him. I found one of Mylla's drawings at the temple. It depicts children playing near a cave. I should ask someone who knows Mylla well to know if they know more about this place. The place Mylla drew is somewhere in Whitestone Hollow. There was some lady running around saying something about a missing girl. I don't know if it was her or not. Camping supplies, yay! That's exactly what we needed. Darian!
We've doubled our manpower at the White Forge.
He looks grimly resolute.
Most folk here are excited, but anxious. There's already news of Raid Saren's gathering at the border. Only a matter of time before someone takes a swing at us. But this time, we'll be ready.
Hmm. No talk about the Eyeless being defeated, huh? I heard the cannons from here. Wengra must be enjoying herself. Oh, I totally forgot to have her... have the others help us. This guy. I don't know. Let's see who can hand this drawing to. Just talk to them. This all goes to show that we've got to look after our town.
This is going to be fantastic. Just wait till they hear about this back home.
Yeah. The mines are back to normal, thanks to you. You're welcome. Gotta watch our backs. Who knows who'll come after the White Forge next? Well, maybe I should talk to whatever his name is. Is it true that the Eyeless were only pets of a ravenous kraken? No. That much wasn't true. We'd better build higher walls. How many be of service? There's a little girl, Mylla, that comes around here. I heard she's been causing trouble for you. She's out of control. Though I suppose one can hardly blame her, what with the way her own mother's always screaming at her. He leans across the counter and speaks to you in a conspiratorial whisper. I mean, where do you think the little rascal learns that kind of behavior, hmm? He tilts his head. Only person I've ever seen her give her a proper talking to is that wild woman who loiters by the hat just south of here. Aska, that's her name. Oh, just talk to Aska. I don't know what it was about, but the girl's eyes were this big. He curves his hands into circles as large as goose eggs. But I suppose someone's got to do it. I told the girl's mother I'd be speaking with Mayor Tarfos if I caught her picking around my shop again. So I guess it worked. He shrugs. Hammond hasn't seen Mylla, but he saw Aska scolding her the other day. Aska's usually by the yurt just south of Hammond's shop. Alright, let's go talk to her then. So we
Adair, go... you were a military man. Ever consider making a career of it?
I did, for a while. Then I heard you could make money shoveling pig shit, and thought that sounded better.
Well, at least it would get you out of the deer wood.
Yeah, she's over here somewhere. So we go from defeating the Eyeless, restoring a moon and a god, supposedly, to looking for a missing girl. Too funny. Show the drawing. Do you recognize this place? She squints at it. Mountains and a cave? A lot of those in these parts. She squints. Those lines there could be standing stones like the ones at Whitestone Hollow. Yep. No offense, but you've got to work some work to do on perspective. Things may have quieted down with the ogres lately, but there's been no shortage of new trouble. Or work for those interested. Just saying. You don't have any work for us. I heard you scolded Royce's girl. She cocks her head, thinking for a moment. Then she begins laughing. You know what that girl did? Snatched a whole chicken from the Grave's Rest. Raw. Told her I'd better not catch her thieving again, but I was trying to do my damnedest not to laugh. Funny kid. She wipes a tear from the corner of her eye. But it's gotta be tough on her, you know? Her old man's working at the battery, and he's one absence away from getting fired. Again. Blazes. Only reason Ludgar still has a job is because Wengra's a softie beneath all that soot. But Mylla, she showed up at the battery the other day and nearly got him sacked. Since then, I've seen her keeping to herself. Spends a lot of time at the temple, come to think of it. Aska mentioned that Mylla doesn't seem to have a lot of guidance. Her father, Ludgar, works at Durgan's battery and has had trouble keeping a job. Mylla got in trouble recently for visiting him, and she's been hanging around the village temple ever since. Alright, let's go to the temple. I mean, I know we just go to this, cave, probably, but interesting to see what these people have to say, of course. Ingram. Our doors are always open and our forge always alight. How may I help? Show him the drawing. It's funny the people's reactions to the drawing. Do you know where this is? He holds the crumpled paper delicately, careful not to smudge the charcoal. After a moment of contemplation, he purses his lips. I'm not sure what I'm looking at, to be honest. He blinks and turns the drawing to hold it right side up. That makes more sense, I think. A cave and some trees? No, those must be address stones out by Whitestone Hollow. I think there's a cave not far from there. I heard Royce's girl Mylla sometimes comes here. He was holding the wrong way. It was so funny. He smiles kindly. She usually sits just there by the forge and draws with some of the charcoal nubs. Poor girl's lonely. The only other children in town are a few years older, and the others that would have been her age were all hollowborn. He shakes her head. His head. At the temple, Engram said that Mylla likes to sit by the furnace and draw. He worries that she's lonely without any friends her own age. Okay, I guess I was gonna sign off. Let's see if we can go to this cave and find her there before we do that. Whitestone Hollow. Bloop. So funny, I literally just ran into that lady. Just trying to see if anyone, you know, had anything else to say. That cave. It was a whole separate, yeah, zone. And there was nothing in it, which just definitely stood out to me. Hopefully nothing here is respawned. Typically they don't. Alright.
Eyes open.
Hello? Little girl? Oh, wait. A wicked? They're running. There's Mylla. Mylla Jovovich. These wicks aren't attacking. Probably going to at some point, though. And the fox from the farmer did run and leap, run and leap. Ooh, what he did to those poor little sheep. Despite the girl singing, the wicks around her are strangely calm. They scratch their claws in the dirt, bloodshot eyes half closed, while the girl sings and hums her song. Does she have to keep singing, otherwise they'll attack? Suddenly, she looks up and notices you. She looks around the cave, as if hoping that you're here for someone else. Nope. Just you, baby. I'm Mylla. These are my friends. She waves an arm towards the wicks, then regards you with some concern. Did you come to play with us? The wicks look up at the worry in her voice, their pupils narrow to pinpricks. Your mother's looking for you. Mylla flinches. Her face scrunches into a defiant little frown. The wicks notice the sudden movement and hiss. Uh-oh. Big tongue! Mila's high-pitched voice cries out at the nearest hissing wicked. Be nice! She turns her attention back to you. I don't want to go back. She yells at me. I just want to play here with my friends. She makes a little mound of dirty snow. Don't think she's gonna be fond of that response. Or that. Or that. You tell a kid they're gonna be in big trouble, they really don't want to come with you. We can give her a cookie. You like sweets? How about a raw Thai cookie? A real raw Thai cookie? I've heard of those. Mila's eyes are wide with wonder. Can I really have one? No, bad children don't get cookies. Oh my god, number four. Can you imagine that? Smile as you drop the cookie on the ground and slowly grind it into the ice with your boot. Oh my god. If I give you this cookie, will you go home to your mother? Mylla nods silently. And then crush it with her boot. No, give her the cookie. Mylla approaches you and carefully takes the cookie into her tiny hands. Transfixed on the delicacy, she begins nibbling on the edges of it as she wordlessly shuffles toward the mouth of the cave. So why are these things not attacking her? The Wicks begin to follow her out, but as they leave the cave they are distracted by the sights and sounds of animals in the wilderness. One by one, the Wicks slink off into the underbrush to hunt. I wonder why they seem to like her. They attack everyone else. See you back in the village, lady. Okay. I got Mylla safely out of the Wick cave. Royce will be waiting for her in Stalwart. Still nothing here. We could have fought them, but they might have hurt her. Probably inadvertently. Okay. Where do we leave again? Oh, here.
You must...
Whoops. Well, that was interesting. We just let her walk off by herself, though. That's kind of messed up. Back to Stalwart. She was here, so... Andra, bless you, my Mylla's back. Royce's wind-chapped face is puffy and her eyes are red. You don't have to click on them. And that girl's not leaving my sight for a week. She glares down at Mylla and clears her throat loudly. Mylla shuffles forward and speaks in a tone of recitation. I'm sorry for all the trouble I caused. Thank you for bringing me home. I promise not to wander off ever again. She glances up at her mother. When Royce nods, Mylla gives you a handful of warm, sweaty coins. No need for that. You keep it. Mylla looks back up at Royce, who nods. Thank you, miss. The girl pockets the grubby coins, still not looking at you. I gotta take coins from a little girl. But when Royce glances away to exchange pleasantries with someone else, Mylla looks at you shyly and whispers, Thank you for not killing my friends. I found a bubble hat back in the woods, by the roots that look like dragon tails. I tried to put it on, but it was too heavy. She glances back at Royce, who's still distracted. A bubble hat? But you can have it if you want. It's still there by the roots. What? A bubble hat? I didn't even tell Papa about the bubble hat. It's by the lake under the big roots. I'm so happy our Mylla's back. Alright, so now we're going back again. Find this bubble hat thing. I wonder if that's what the name of it really is, bubble hat. Well, she just doesn't know what the hell it is. I guess it's some kind of mind control thing. And she dropped it in the roots on her way out? Does it control the Wicks with it, maybe? Big roots. Big roots by the lake. Is that what these big mounds are? Big roots. What the hell? Oh, that?
Something over there.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Avera's diving helmet. Plus 20 defense against poison attacks, plus 35 defense against dragon breath attacks. We need this for fighting the dragon. Or the dragons. Minus 1 perception. This diving helmet appears to have been a Valian experiment in assisting underwater exploration. Though it only holds a small amount of air, a clever magical enchantment pressurizes the bell enough to allow for deeper dives than are normally possible. Yeah, say one of us need to use this when fighting a dragon. Yeah, look at all that stuff. Plus 3 might and retaliation. I'll give that up. Oh, she can't wear something on her head. I say give it to Durance. Look at him. It'll help him against dragon breath so he won't die trying to keep us all alive. That's so funny. Yeah. Poor Durance. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Next episode, we're headed to that fen, whatever it is. To finish that. The Phylactery's Promise. In Starwood, a violent scout was brought down by the town guards, but not before she was observed demanding information as to my whereabouts. Prior to Stalwart, the scout traveled through a bog on the edge of Irglanfath to the southwest of the White March. I expect I will find her employer thereabouts. So that will be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.